first speaker in the panel this evening is Mr. Babban Ghilasi, the Vice President of Do Center Zagros for Les Droits de l'Homme. I call upon him to present his address.
Thank you, President. Ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, defensor of human rights and freedom. In my short presentation, I try to present an overview of the situation of Iraqi Kurds before arriving to that conclusion to go for a referendum for independence. The misfortune of the Kurds is the result of the Sykes-Picot Agreement and the secret understanding between France and Great Britain following the defeat of the Ottoman Empire. This treaty has resulted in the forced separation of the Kurds into four parts: Iran, Iraq, Turkey, and Syria. For several generations, the Kurds have been subjected to repression. The history of the Kurds is one of the most sanguinary and tragic. It is a story of atrocities, deportations, injustice, and genocide. The Kurds were not even allowed to speak the language of their parents. Despite these painful trials, the Kurds proudly maintained their tradition and culture. They resisted against the powers that dreamed of seeing them disappear. After the Gulf War in 1991, the Middle East region faced unprecedented political change. This new element rekindled the flame that was dormant in each one in order to lead Kurdistan towards its freedom. The Kurds have taken advantage of this new opportunity to create their regional government and parliament. In 2005, the Kurdish government actively contributed to the establishment of a new constitution in Iraq, guaranteeing democracy, federalism, and the principle of a true partnership. The authorities in Baghdad quickly ignored the constitution as well as their commitment to Article 140, which stipulated the return of the Kurdish populations to their territory of origin, known as among Gime, disputed areas. Baghdad has even decided not to pay the financial allocation for the Kurdistan region, which represents 70% of the Iraqi budget. When Daesh attacked the region 2 years ago, the Iraqi National Army has completely abandoned the region. It also left to Daesh the most modern weapons and equipment provided by the United States. In order to disestablize the regional government of Kurdistan and fight its democratic system, Kurdistan was invaded by the Islamists of Daesh. Faced with this heavily armed Daesh, the Baghdad government refused to provide defense materials to the Peshmerga. The Kurdish fighters, with their will, their pace, and determination, were able to defend the civilian population. The Peshmergas finally managed to stop this barbarian movement, to repulse it, and finally to liberate the territories occupied by Daesh. They even managed to expel Daesh from several areas of the disputed zones. The actions of the Iraqi government had the effect of breaking the already very fragile trust between the Kurdish people and the leaders of Baghdad. Indeed, several factors today threaten the young Kurdish democracy. The deep wounds inflicted on Kurdistan by the regime of Saddam Hussein are not yet cured, and the Kurds have suffered the atrocities of Daesh or the Islamic State. They have not yet finished with Daesh's self-proclaimed state. The Kurds feel threatened by the ideological militia of al-Hashd al-Sha'bi, popular mobilization supported by countries hostile to the Kurds. The status quo of the regional government would not allow it to guarantee the security of its population. It would direct Kurdistan towards an unknown future and would be the cry of all the lot of hostile countries. The experience of the past decades shows that Iraq would seek to homogenize its society by denying the rights of other ethnic and religious minorities and ultimately turn to a sectarian war. On the other hand, Kurdistan has become a factor of stability for the region. That is why more than 1,800,000 refugees, internally displaced persons, as well as refugees from neighboring countries have sought protection in Kurdistan. Through an elaborate strategy, the Kurdistan Regional Government works to strengthen cultural and religious diversity. It officially recognized and protected several religious minorities threatened by the fundamentalist group. Therefore, in order to protect the Kurdish people against possible provocations or aggressions or acts of war against the sovereignty of the Kurdistan people, the Kurdistan Regional Government believes in the establishment of an independent state for the Kurdish people. It demands that the Kurds take their fate democratically. It simply asks for referendum on the independence of Iraqi Kurdistan as specified in United Nations Charter. For the Kurds, this is the time to enjoy, like other nations, their democratic rights. Thank you.